Hi everyone, isn't it great to be here? And it means that Christmas is very, very nearly here. Isn't it exciting? I'm excited, are you? Well, I've got a very, very special story to tell you. And it isn't about Father Christmas, but hey ho, it's about some very, very special people. And it's why we celebrate Christmas. And there are some very, very special people that we're going to meet on the way, and some special animals too. And we begin in a place called Bethlehem, which is a very, very long way away. And we're coming to an old cow shed that's behind an inn. And it's a very, very chilly night, with clear sky and lots of twinkly stars. And there is one star in particular that is very, very bright in the sky. The owls notice it first because they're very, very wise. And they know that something amazing and wonderful is going to happen. What sort of noise do you think owls make? Especially when they're excited, because they were very excited. Well, they rush to the cow shed to tell two robins, to let them know that something amazing was going to happen. And they were hooting, and then the robins were tweeting and twittering. And then the cow, whose home it was, he realised that something very strange was going on. And they told him too. What sort of noise does a cow make? What do you think? You have a go and see if you can make a noise like that. Well then, they all rushed out to have a look at this beautiful star that was high in the sky. There, and they gazed in wonder. It was so beautiful, so beautiful. Meanwhile, there were two people coming towards Bethlehem. They had had a very, very long journey. Can you remember what their names are? Mary and Joseph, and a donkey. Mary and Joseph had come all the way from Nazareth. Mary had got a baby in her tummy, and it was very, very nearly time for that baby to come into the world. Bethlehem was a very, very busy place with lots and lots of people. And Joseph and Mary tried very hard to find somewhere to stay out of the chilly cold night. But they couldn't find anywhere because everywhere was full. There were so many people. And they were getting really anxious, and Mary's tummy was beginning to get a bit painful. And they came to the very last inn on the road out of Bethlehem. And Joseph knocked on the door. Bang, bang, bang. He was really, really getting a bit worried, I have to tell you. The innkeeper came to the door and he saw Mary and Joseph and a very tired looking donkey. What sort of noise do you think a donkey makes? Probably not a lot of noise when he's tired, but normally be quite noisy, wouldn't he? Anyway, the innkeeper looks at them and he says, "Terribly sorry, I haven't got any room. All of my rooms are just chock block full of people. There really isn't anywhere." And then he suddenly has a thought. There's an old cow shed at the back of the inn. It's not particularly nice, but it would keep them dry out of the cold night air. So he shows them the way to the cow shed at the back of the inn. And Mary makes herself as comfortable as she can, and Joseph sits by his wife and watches her, and the donkey lays down because he's really tired.
God, as I am tired,
and the owls and the robin, mooing and hooting and tweeting, were all safely back in the shelter of the cowshed. And they watched in amazement as Mary and Joseph and the donkey all came in to their cowshed and made themselves as comfortable as they could be. And it wasn't very long before Jesus was born. And the owls, who are very wise, knew immediately that this tiny, tiny, fragile baby was the reason that that bright and beautiful star was shining in the sky. And they knew that they were very, very lucky, very blessed to be there as this new baby was born, this baby Jesus, Saviour of our world. Meanwhile, out on the hillside, there were shepherds looking after their sheep, and they'd seen that star too, and they'd been a bit puzzled. It was very beautiful. It was almost as if it was speaking to them, and they stood and watched. And then suddenly the sky was full of light and sound, and they couldn't really believe what they were seeing. And they looked at each other in amazement. They'd really no idea what was going on. And actually, they were frightened. I think I'd be frightened too, wouldn't you? And they fell down on their knees and they covered their heads with their arms. And then they heard beautiful voices filling their ears, saying, "Don't be afraid, get up. Get up, come quickly. The most wonderful thing has happened. Didn't you see the star? The most wonderful baby has been born. And he will be the saviour of the world. Come quickly, come quickly. Come to the cowshed. Come and worship this holy child." And before the bright and beautiful angels had left, they showed the dazzled shepherds where to go. And as the shepherds and some of their sheep, and our naughty little sheep, hey-ho, had found their way to the cowshed, and the sheep didn't want to miss out, did they? What sort of noise, what sort of sound did they make as they were coming down the hillside? I bet they were excited too, weren't they? Very exciting bar. more special visitors that are coming following the star. They've come a very, very long way, and they've been following that star for a very long time. They've been looking at their charts, and they knew that it meant that a king had been born, a new king. Not any old king, but a very, very special king. Well, of course, they sort of thought that a king would be born in a palace. So they go to Herod's palace to see if the newborn king is there. Herod is a bit puzzled by that. But no, there isn't a new king there. But then they decide that perhaps they weren't quite following the star, not where the star wanted them to go. And so off they go and properly follow the star this time. And they come to the cowshed too. They're very puzzled by this. A king in a cowshed. Surely that can't be right, can it? But they go very, very quietly. They leave their camels outside and they peek through the entrance, and there they see Mary and Joseph, the shepherds, the angel, all standing, kneeling, watching, adoring this newborn baby. And they too go in very quietly. There we are. And we've got Caspar. That's an excellent name, isn't it? Oh, sorry, Joseph. Caspar. Balthazar. And Melchior. There we are. Aren't they splendid? Don't they look amazing? Look at those. And they have brought special presents for this baby. Special presents that mean a great deal. One of them has brought gold, one of them has brought frankincense, and one of them has brought myrrh. So they offer their gifts to this newborn baby. I think Mary and Joseph must have been a little bit puzzled by all this attention. Maybe they didn't realise quite how special this baby, Jesus, would be. And Jesus takes it all in his stride. He's as good as gold. I'm not sure he always was, but if he was having a bit of a cry, what sort of noise do you think he would make? Do you think you can make a sound like a baby crying? Bet your mum and dad won't like that, will they? No. So there we are. We are just about at the end of our story. There they are, all worshipping this very, very special baby. And do you know that Jesus is the best present we could be given? You'll be very lucky, I'm sure, if you've been very good, of course. And we'll have lots of presents for Christmas. And when you're opening your presents, I want you to remember baby Jesus, God's gift to us, the best present we could ever have, a present that is with us now and with us always. Have a very happy Christmas.
Thank you. herself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay.
Make the Yuletide gay.
From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now. The fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now. Christmas, let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay.
Make the Yuletide gay.
From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days of yore.